Hello students, I feel elated to welcome you all to our English class. Today we are going to see one small tiny grammar part. Begin with the inversion. Before that, you shall say the structure of the sentence. So far, we have studied all positive sentences follow this structure. Subject, verb, complements. Subject, verb, complements. But in certain cases, we can change the word order to verb plus subject. Verb plus subject. And that is called as an inversion. Verb plus subject, that is called as an inversion. So dear students, inversion means putting the verb before the subject. It is a literary technique in which the normal order of words is reversed. When do we use inversion? Most probably, we will use inversions in questions. We use inversions in questions. Example, does he come here? Does he come here? Apart from questions, we can use inversion in the following cases. The first one is, already we know well, inversions used in the questions. For example, does he work here? Does he work here? Here, does is a verb. Does is a verb. He is a subject. He is a subject. Already you all know what is inversion. Inversion means putting a verb before the subject. So if you see in the sentence, does he work here? Here, what is verb? Does. And what is subject? He. So that only it is called as a inversion. The verb we are adding before the subject, it may be a auxiliary verb or modal verb. It may be auxiliary verb or modal verb. Before entering to the next point, let me say the hints of the conditional class. Already we have studied in 10th standard. Now we shall revise it. Already you all know about conditional classes. Conditional classes, we have two parts. One is if class, another one is main class. If class in the sense, it will start with the condition word if. In main class, there will be a complete sense of the sentence. There will be a three types of conditions in condition classes. Probable condition, improbable condition and impossible conditions are there in conditional classes. Now, we can see the structure of the conditional classes. The first one is probable condition. In probable condition, the if class will be in simple present tense. The main class will be will plus infinitive, will plus infinitive. The second type, improbable condition. In improbable condition, the verb will be in a simple past tense. In main class, would plus infinitive. Third type is impossible condition. In impossible condition, the if class will be in a past perfect. If class will be in a past perfect, in main class, would have plus verb 3. Next, we can see the inversion in conditional forms. Inversions in conditional forms. In conditional class, the condition word if is dropped and the inverted forms take the place of the if class. The if is dropped and the inversion take the place of the if class. The condition word if is rephrased with should, were, had. These words can call as the inversions. We have to use should for first conditional type, where for second conditional type, had for third conditional type. For example, if you should need to meet me, you can call this number. The answer is, should you need to meet me, you can call this number. Here, the if is rephrased with the inversion word should. After the inversion word only, we are using subject. The next example is, if I were a rich man, I would help all the poor. The answer is, were I a rich man, I would help all the poor. The next example is, if I had come earlier, I would have met my grandmother. The answer is, had I come earlier, I would have met my grandmother. Next, inversions in complex sentences. Usually, complex sentences begin with us. This us can be rephrased with because of, due to, since, owing to, on account of. For example, As I am weak, I couldn't walk. Because of my weakness, I couldn't walk. Or else, due to my weakness, I couldn't walk. On account of my weakness, I couldn't walk. Since I was weak, I couldn't walk. We shall go with the next point. Inversions in some adverbial beginners. Adverbial beginners like hardly, barely, scarcely, seldom, rarely, and never. These words convey a negative meanings. These words convey a negative meaning. For example, I have seldom seen a rainbow, in bracket hardly. You have to begin the sentence with hardly. The answer is hardly I have seen a rainbow. So dear students, keep it in your mind. In the question, if they given a beginners in the bracket with the same beginner only, we have to start the answer. If not, if they didn't give a beginner in the questions, means we have to take a verb after the subject. With that verb only, we have to start the answer. Next, we can see some exercises. If it were not for the chill climate, I would like that place. You see students, in this sentence, they didn't give a beginners in the bracket. So what we have to do it after the subject, what the verb is there? Here, what's the verb? Where. With that where, we have to start the answer. So the answer is, were it not for the chill climate, I would like that place. Next example, if I were a bird, I would fly. The answer is, were I a bird, I would fly. Here too, after the subject, what's the verb? With that verb, we have started the answer. Next example is, if you are late once again, you will lose your job. You have to begin the sentence with should. So what's the answer? Should you be late once again, you will lose your job. Next example is, if he had explained the problem, I would have helped him. Begin with had. So you have to start the sentence with had. Had he explained the problem, I would have helped him. Another one example, if he had walked fast, he would have caught the bus. Here, they didn't give a beginners in the bracket, so you have to start with the verb. Had he walked fast, he would have caught the bus. So, dear students, most probably, our begin with the questions will be asked in conditional forms. Next, some exercises for you I have given as a worksheet. Do it kindly, without fail.